Yorkshire's rolling farmland is home to 500,000 cattle. They look placid, but cows can be lethal, especially to dog walkers.
Ambulance service, is the patient breathing?
A desperate rambler is on the phone to 999 operators.
Trampled on by cows at Massham. She's got an abdo injury that said bruising to her abdomen, and she was knocked out temporarily.
Cattle can weigh more than a ton. Dr. Jez and paramedics George and Pete know they can inflict massive injuries.
So secure the front, secure the back. Prices down, just out of here.
Pilot Lee is taking off for a farm on the edge of the Dales.
We're heading to Masham, which is a nice part of North Yorkshire, for a lady that's been trampled by some cows. And lots of footpaths go across fields where there's cows, and when they've got calves as well, cows can get quite skittish.
There are reports the cows are still surrounding their victim. Dispatcher James is diverting ground paramedic Al to the farm to help.
What's your ETA, please, George?
15 minutes.
So it looks like Al's going to meet you there, so the police need to help clear the cows, George.
Can confirm it's to get rid of the cows.
You
just feel really vulnerable when you're
like
it out, don't you? It's just horrible.
If the farmers have a big stick, it's not so bad.
But if they're not moving, that worries me.
Ground paramedic Al has arrived at the farm.
I've just located the patient. No idea where they are, have I?
There's cows behind us at 6 o'clock.
Cows to the right of us as well.
Low left, by the gate.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry,
yeah,
low right,
yeah,
by the gate.
Yeah. No cows visible. We're going to go into this cropped field, right, yeah. 1 o'clock, low.
Lee's landing behind the hedgerow, where their patient is lying.
Okay, so I've got wires, 3 and 12 o'clock, committed to land.
You're looking good left.
Yeah.
There are no cows here, but there have been.
No.
The defibrillator landed in a cow pat.
Oh, mate.
Passing walkers have scattered the herd.
Cows are in this bit of field, so if you can.
The patient's partner used his shirt to keep her warm.
We've got the people here, Yannicka.
Pete can get to work.
Yannicka, my name's Pete. This is Jez, he's one of the doctors. What's happening, Yannicka? How many cows?
About 30 odd.
Oh, 30 odd. Okay, have you got any pain anywhere?
Yes, in my abdomen.
Okay.
I'm tingling all over my face and arms and legs.
Well, let's get you sorted out.
Yannicka Tavet was out walking when she was attacked. A friend who lives nearby called to help.
She's been dog walking and the beast have trampled her. It appears that in order to try and escape, she's climbed a tree after she'd been trampled and then fallen down from that as well. She's complaining of severe pains in her abdomen and her lung.
Where's that hurting? Okay, you relax your arm for me then.
This couldn't have come at a worse time for their patient.
Have you got any medical problems we need to know about?
Yeah, I've got cancer and I'm due to go into hospital a week tomorrow.
Okay. Can you straighten your arm for me, Yannicka? Thank you.
The cows are still in the area, but paramedic Al, who is on ground duty today, is on guard.
I'm on cow duty. It's one of those occasions where hitting something with a big stick might actually prove useful. Cows generally don't like people being shouty and noisy and waving things at them. So if they do start coming, I'll make an attempt to scare them off before I run for my life.
Legs feel okay?
Lower down hurts.
Whereabouts?
My lower legs and my feet were stood on.
Any pain when I'm touching you around there?
Yannicka's abdomen took the full weight of one cow. It looks like it was protecting its calf from her dog, Goose. Dr. Jez fears his patient has a serious internal injury and her heart rate is worrying.
I just think that's just a funny looking ECG.
Have you had any cardiac problems before, Yannicka?
I had an ECG 2 days, not clear which day, Sunday. I had one on Thursday and it was normal.
If the attack has damaged Yannicka's heart, she's in urgent need of specialist care. But the team fear the cows may return.
We've got a crew here at all.
Well, this is the problem, getting the crew to us.
Yeah.
Because no one knows which entrance is which.
Yeah.
Pete's preparing to fly their patient.
Right, Jess, let's get her on the scoop,
yeah.
Get her straightened up,
yeah.
Have a good look at that tummy,
yeah.
And then take it from there.
Yeah.
And take hold of your belt, OK?
Am I going to
hang
do on, that? Hang
yeah.
On, no, let me try and do it myself.
OK.
OK.
Yeah.
There we go.
Oh!
Yannicka's a former soldier, but her pain is overwhelming.
Where's it hurting?
Okay.
Let's get her straight, get her flattened down, we'll get access. Can we bend down these?
I don't
Will this knee bend? There we go, marvellous.
Pilot Lee is going to move HeliMed 98 closer to their patient.
That's sore there, is it?
Okay. Both sides sore.
Both sides.
ECG says it's yeah, I'm not quite sure what's going on with that. Yannicka, can we straighten this arm, please? Is that okay?
Yeah.
That's it. It's just quite. Before we give you anything, it's really important. It's really important that we get an idea what your blood pressure's doing.
Okay.
Then we can give you some painkillers.
Definitely quiet on that right side. Mm.
It looks like she has several broken ribs, which are affecting her breathing.
Yeah.
I just want to have a little feel of his tummy if I can.
Yeah.
Her abdominal pain is more worrying.
There, really hurts.
That's sore there. Okay, darling.
Yannicka was out to take her mind off impending cancer surgery. Her friends were horrified by what happened.
We're still doing a VP.
Yeah, I know, I was.
Ow, my arm.
Just here, Yannicka. I'm here.
Yannicka, just do this with your right fist. Just to get your veins up.
As the team fight to stabilise their patient, HeliMed 98 is being moved.
This cannula is in.
10664 BP. Okay. Yeah, sorry, George.
They're going to fly her to the major trauma centre at Leeds General Infirmary. George is alerting the hospital team.
Morphine, yep.
Now that she's been given painkillers, Yannicka is able to talk more easily.
Do you remember what happened?
Yeah, I had the dog on the lead, really tight lead.
Yeah.
And one of the cows took offence to the dog, trampled the dog, and I pulled the dog close to me.
Yeah.
Oh, my arm hurts.
It's all right.
Police are investigating the incident. Several ramblers have died as a result of cow attacks in North Yorkshire in recent years.
Just going to give you a little anti-sickness injection here as well, Yannicka, OK?
So what we're going to do now is going to start getting you packaged up. We're going to get you ready so we can fly you. So we're going to fly you to Leeds.
If Yannicka has suffered internal injuries, it could delay her life-saving cancer surgery.
Just let your legs go straight, sweetheart.
There's another medical concern for the team.
She's tested COVID negative 2 days ago because she's having surgery, so I think the risk is very low. And if we're in level two, so we need goggles, this, that's effectively level two PPE and a gown.
Yeah, no worries, yeah.
Her friends are concerned, but there'll be no familiar face at her bedside.
I recognise they might not be able to get in.
Yeah.
Just if I'm there, if you can tell them
like,
now.
Yeah, like
or at least I can.
It's
make,
just with COVID. I'd normally, obviously, they would let you in.
As far as any other interventions, I'm happy we don't have to do anything else.
I think so, yeah. She's had three morphine.
Yeah, I'm happy with the C-spine.
On lift. Ready, steady, lift. Yannicka, we're just going to lift you up, OK?
It's going to feel a little bit weird.
Yeah. Is everyone ready?
Yeah. Ready.
On lift. Ready, steady.
Yannicka is on her way to scans.
You give me a handle on this side.
That's it. Keep going.
Which will determine the extent of her internal injuries.
She's been trampled across the chest and abdomen. And I think when they've done some observations, they've also found something a bit unusual on her ECG. There is a possibility that the chest trauma could have affected her heart in some way.
HeliMed 98 will have Yannicka in hospital in less than 15 minutes.
Engines both to flight.
Right, so I'm just going to move the nose forward.
Every day is a school day for Dr. Jez.
I've learned something on this job. If you throw a monitor over a fence and there's cows nearby, just be careful where you throw it.
Right, we're cleared into Leeds. We have 7 minutes to run.
Yannicka's blood pressure is low. The team will be relieved when she reaches resus.
Standard approach into LGI heli deck. Wind is slightly behind us, so we'll go past and then just do a right-hand turn.
HeliMed 98, this is LGI heli deck. We have all crews on station and ready to receive you, over.
We're inbound, we'll be 2 minutes. Joining from the north, HeliMed 98.
Good on the left.
Okay, committed to that, over the H.
At last, Yannicka is close to the specialist care she desperately needs.
How's that pain in your tummy and your chest now? Still there, is it? Is it any better, any worse?
Spread my chest.
In the next hour, the hospital trauma team will deliver their verdict. A walk in the country could have devastating consequences for Yannicka.